Welcome, all friends in the Dhamma. The Buddha tell us to develop mindfulness of the four foundations. The first foundation is mindfulness of body and body in the body. Okay? The second foundation, mindfulness of sensation and sensation in the sensation. Okay? Not only sensation outside, sensation in the sensation. Okay? And mindfulness of mind and mind in the mind. And mindfulness of mental quality and mental quality in the mental quality. That means more inside, more turning inverse, 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 inverse. Okay? Mindfulness of body very important. So today we will develop great mindfulness. If you develop mindfulness of body and body in the body, one word, mindfulness of the whole well-being of the body. Really simple. What you feel now? Even you open eye, you just mindfulness, awareness, knowing, seeing the whole well-being of this body. You feel relaxed immediately. You feel calm immediately, okay? Instantly. You don't have to do anything. Only you fulfill the mindfulness of both body and body in the body. One word. The whole well-being of the body. The whole. Okay?
So the whole.
The whole?
Yeah, the whole is our thinking and our feelings.
Oh, no, no. I start with body first. Don't get about your thinking or your feeling. I start with the first foundation, body foundation first. Okay? Don't go too deep. My phrase of body and body in the body first. Body and body in the body, or just see how you got well-being of the body, the whole well-being, the whole well-being. You got calmness, okay? When you got calmness, come from mindfulness of body in the body. In the calmness, you can realize thinking, arising, disappearing by itself. If you got good mindfulness of body and body in the body, or one word, mindfulness of the whole well-being of body, then you're not lost in thought. Thought arising, thought disappearing. Any sensual pressure arising, sensual pressure disappearing. Because you got very good mindfulness of body, the first foundation. Okay? And then you can send or can see from mindfulness, awareness. You can see from awareness, not only the whole body, not only the whole well-being of body. You can see from awareness of body, see all mental phenomena, your thought, your desire, what arising, it disappearing. Because you stay on the body mindfulness like you stay on the bank of the river. You not jump inside into the dirtiness of water. Dirty water. You not jump inside. Now you just stay on the bank of the river. Stay mindful on the body, on the well-being of body. Okay? You got any sensual pressure? Don't jump inside. Only stay on the bank of the river, on the body. See how the well-being of the body first. When you got the well-being of the body, then all in your mind, something not good, it arising, disappearing. Okay? Thought arising, it disappearing. Then we just see and let go. How to see and let go? mindfulness first on the body, on the whole body first. Then what arising, then it disappearing. You only the knower and seer. And this is what you learn from the Zen Buddhism. Zen Buddhism just tell you, now I show you how you got mindfulness of body more and more. It will happen like this. It will happen like, now mindfulness of body first, mindfulness of body. Wake up, how to wake up, mindfulness of body, awareness of body. Now you sit like this, not wake up, or maybe you sit like this, not wake up. But if you just lean back your back slowly, a little by little, lean back, backwards. You got awareness or not? Because awareness will tell you, no more, not lean backwards, more, otherwise you will fall off, okay? Awareness, okay? Awareness, now your awareness away, lost in thought, lost in emotion, or tired, then awareness of body outside first. By awareness and see bodily movement. Can you see bodily movement with awareness? Or can you see hand movement? Not by eye, because you move your hand backwards. Can you be aware? Just follow me. Now, can you see hand movement by awareness? Or you raise your hand. Can you see hand movement when you raise your hand? This is seeing by awareness, and you got something wake up. Wake up and see how you raise your hand. You know, I found myself when I shave my hair. When I shave my hair in front, I can see my face in the middle. Not wake up. But when I shave my hair back, I cannot see my hair from the mirror because this is backward. Then immediately there is something the knower or seer wake up. Oh, good, you shave your hair, good. And how you see? You don't see by eye, cannot see in the mirror, but you see by awareness. You see by feeling. Feeling and aware. Now feeling and aware and dress yourself. Feeling and aware. Every morning you dress your hair or not? Can you just feel how you're dressing and see how you dress your hair? Can you see? Can you feel? Can you see? Can you feel? Can you see? Then you got Zen mind. The Zen master say Zen mind. Okay? Now, your mind always not wake up. When wake up, Zen tradition use the word Zen mind. Okay? Zen mind, seeing yourself. And now, I just tell you, now you just slowly lean backwards, only a little. Something wake up or not? To carry your body. Oh, not falling. And if you more going, it more. Oh, stop. This is pure mind. Or Zen mind. Or one mind. Or clear consciousness. And this is the mind that getting on the path to enlightenment, okay? When you wake up with this clear mind, with mindfulness and awareness, always seeing yourself, then you get on the path direct to the enlightenment, okay? How you get on the path? Now when you not aware of yourself because you are very lazy. Oh, you are very lazy. When you are lazy, sitting this way, your pure mind disappear because it become monkey mind. Okay? So just don't try to fight with your thought. Your thought, okay, you awareness of body first. Now awareness of body. Thought disappear by itself. Thought disappear by itself because you wake up your monkey mind to be Zen mind. Zen mind or consciousness, okay? Now you lose consciousness because your consciousness always go to your thought. When you're thinking too much, you lose your consciousness. But when you exercise, play sport. Now play sport. How you feel? And now today I will tell you, try this sport. I will wake up your mind by, you know, the darting game. You do darting. And now do it now. What happening? Just pretend. Something wake up or not? There is awareness, more wake up and sensing yourself. Say that. Again. This is your pure mind wake up, clear consciousness. But it, you not recognize it because you don't know this is we call clear mind, clear consciousness. Today you learn to know about your clear mind first. Clear mind, it become aware. When you do darting game now, darting. Your eye look at me, now you darting to me. Darting me, I darting you, I look at you. Now, your hand like this. Now, do it. Your eye see me, but your awareness see yourself. And stay there. Okay? So learn to know your mind first, your pure mind, because you never realize your pure mind. When you play sport, tennis, if you know about pure mind, you can play sport, any kind of sport from your spirit, spiritual. You got exercise and got spiritual wake up if you know about this thing, right? Play sport, wake up. Okay? You can rely, come this way, and when you are hitting, what happening when you are hitting? This is pure mind, wake up. Okay? And pure mind, seeing the way you hit, and stay there. Okay? Any kind of sport, or even swimming. Your eye look at the wall, otherwise you hit the wall, swimming. But you are swimming more and more, you got movement. When you got movement, you got awareness. Awareness can see the whole body flipping. The flipping on your feet, okay? This is vipassana. Vipassana. Okay, on the body foundation. So, if you have time, just exercise in a day. You got good health and you got vipassana. Sing. Okay? Or exercise. And close your eye. Now close your eye and exercise. How you see yourself? You see yourself from awareness. Okay? So awareness is your mind. Who will go rebirth the next time? This awareness wake up will go to higher level. But if you don't know about awareness of your mind wake up, you don't know. Okay? Then the last minute you come, you got scary. Then awareness not wake up. Then not wake up. Then you cannot see yourself breathing slowly, more slowly, seeing by awareness, seeing the breathing become slower, slower, to the last breathing. So you just know when you die, you just awareness and see your breathing more slowly and softly, gently, until the last breathing you still can see, then your mind, pure mind consciousness, go rebirth to the high level. Because you wake up, the last minute you wake up, you see even how you die the last second. Okay? But if you got scared, you don't know, because you got pain, then you cannot wake up. You cannot see your last breathing, that you got darkness, go to the lower level, okay? So that's why what we practice to prepare to die, okay? How to die peacefully, how to die consciously, how to die mindfully. Understand now? So that's why you must develop together. Now you look at me, you got concentration. You listen to my talk, concentration. But how about you got awareness, seeing how you sitting, seeing how you movement, seeing bodily movement, seeing this body sitting and doing nothing, seeing this body sitting, casually sitting and breathing, sitting and breathing. Can you see this body sitting and breathing? See by here, awareness. Can you see? Very important. Because when you practice to come back, turn inwards, turn backward to your pure mind, then the last minute come, not scary. You know how prepared to die. Just stay with your spiritual. This body return to earth. It's going to die. Okay, never mind. But my spirit will go rebirth. Where is your spirit? Here. Spirit sensing, seeing, awareness and see the last breathing until the last breathing. Then your spirit go next rebirth. And you can make your aim to come back to Perth, next rebirth. This one, like the Lama. Lama, you know, Lama make their aim come to Tibet again the next life, okay? This is your power of mind, okay? So that's why all monks and holiness got this aura, okay? You got this aura or not? No, because you not see your bodily movement, bodily action, not see this body, how eating, how drinking, how talking, how sitting, how relax. But sometimes you see yourself when you take a rest on the beach. Don't worry anything. Just see how you relax. You can see yourself sometimes when you relax on the beach. Oh, with the nature. You get to sing yourself sometime. So you start from this thing. Yeah? Not only sing sometime, but sing more and more in the whole day. Okay? In daily life. Now, I always got sing, like I got spotlight, seeing myself. I walk, I got this consciousness, awareness, sense myself, sensing my walking, sensing my space, sensing my thought. Even I got thought. This got sensing and thought arising and disappearing. Okay? So that's why we develop. We must start from body foundation. Develop very good mindfulness, sensing or seeing with awareness, body and body well-being together. Okay? It's not difficult. Okay? Now, even you stay at home, you are a housewife, you got disturbed, nobody, you feel alone, you feel lonely. Now you're not lonely anymore because you got yourself wake up. and just see this body cleaning, okay, this body washing, you not feel lonely anymore because you come back to your spiritual, okay? This is your spiritual, and you not feel any suffering. Even you got sickness, just sickness on your body, but not sickness to your mind and spirit. Because your mind and spirit wake up already. Pain on your body, okay? Sick on your body, but not pain and sick to your mind, okay? So you must know the first step, wake up first. Wake up first, okay? When you wake up, then now you look at me, listen to my talk. This is concentration. But concentration and seeing yourself together, seeing yourself, the body outside and the body inside, all one word. Seeing the whole well-being of yourself, even you listen to my talk, can you see the whole well-being or not? This is vipassana. Look at me, listen to my talk. This is concentration. You must develop both concentration and concentration on any object, but vipassana or inside, see yourself. Okay? Because the whole day, you don't develop awareness in yourself. You only develop concentration. Facebook concentration, WhatsApp. And you don't see this person now, WhatsApp for half an hour and tired. Okay, typing. You only do concentration the whole day. You never develop more awareness, seeing how you work, how you do Facebook, how you do WhatsApp. Okay, when you do WhatsApp too much, your well-being become not well-being, become poor and become tired. Then okay, enough. You can observe, you lose your well-being, okay? So that's why today I just tell you more develop mindfulness meditation. This is we call mindfulness meditation. That means meditation by concentration on my talk. Look at me, this is meditation. But mindfulness, see yourself. Mindfulness meditation. That means you got concentration on my talk, listening, but see how you sit, how you lay there, and see how the whole well-being of your body. Then you got this, seeing your body, the whole well-being, you got vipassana. Okay? Vipassana means seeing yourself. How you doing? Okay? How you feeling? Or one word, how the well-being you have. Okay? Then you not deserve. Okay? People speak bad, you not see yourself, you got disturbance. But when people talk to you, you talk to people, you awareness, seeing you still got well-being or not, then you're not lost. That means the Buddha tell us to develop mindfulness of the four foundation. The first one, you must develop well with mindfulness, seeing the body, the whole well-being, not only the body movement, the whole well-being. Okay? And now what happening? Open eye. You don't have to practice meditation by this method. Only one method. Mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of the body. You can open eye. Even you listen to my talk, just keep seeing the whole well-being of this body. And don't think about what method. Now I give you the Buddha method. The Buddha method is mindfulness of body. Okay? Doesn't matter, focus your breath, focus the rising, falling, focus sensation. No, that is not step by step. The first step must mindfulness of body first, okay? you go too fast, okay? Start from mindfulness of body, the whole body outside and inside. And what is the whole body? The well-being. And see what happening. Even I look at you, you look at me, I see my well-being of the whole body, the whole well-being of the body. Can you see the whole well-being of the body? Then you get more mindfulness, awareness of the whole relaxation of the of body outside. The whole good vital side smoothly as a whole, not focus one by one. See as a whole to fulfill mindfulness of the whole body. Now you can stop. You only focus breathing, you only focus stop movement. That's not the whole of the body. It's only a part of body. Anyhow, you can develop contemplation together, how breathing. Not focus, but what different? You focus your breathing, you use your brain, okay? You look at me, seeing me by your eye, but awareness, contemplation with awareness. So awareness, seeing the whole body first. Awareness, seeing the whole body, seeing the whole wellness, the whole well-being of body first. Then when you got awareness, seeing the whole well-being of body, you can develop contemplation from awareness. Awareness is your mind. Awareness, seeing the whole well-being, this is your mind. Then develop, now you can develop contemplation from your mind. So wake up first. When you wake up with awareness, seeing the whole well-being, your mind wake up. When your mind wake up, when you develop contemplation of how breathing in, how breathing out, how breathing in long, how breathing out long. This contemplation from awareness, not from your thought, not from your brain. Your brain is not your mind. Your mind not your brain. Your mind is the one who know this body well-being, okay? Now, awareness and see the whole well-being of body and together, contemplation from awareness, how breathing in long, how breathing out long, seeing by awareness, okay? But seeing as a whole first, okay? Wake up first, then contemplation of breathing together. Then you got seeing with contemplation, not from the brain, but from your consciousness or your awareness. Now, wake up first before you develop mindfulness of breathing. Okay? Otherwise, you not wake up. You only do concentration of breathing because you not wake up. In the teaching, in the sutta, in the Buddhist doctrine, anapanasati means interpreted, translated into mindfulness of breathing. That means if you wake up, you will know how to be mindful of breathing. But if you not wake up, you are always translated anapanasati into concentration of breathing. It's big difference, okay? So wake up, then you will translate as the Buddha used the word anapanasati, mindfulness of breathing, okay? Not concentration on breathing, mindfulness. Mindful first, mindful wake up first. Now stay mindful. I just tell you, stay aware, stay mindful. Seeing the whole well-being first. Wake up, this will help you wake up first. When you wake up, then mindfulness of how breathing in from here, not from the brain. Otherwise, you always focus from the brain, then 5 years, 10 years, you got stuck. Okay, wake up first. Mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of the body, outside, inside, together, or relax the whole body. Can you? And see, relax and see how the whole well-being, and just stay there. And then when you wake up, you got natural mindfulness. Now breathing in, you got natural mindfulness, awareness, there you got mindfulness already. Mindfulness of breathing, mindfulness of breathing nicely, gently, naturally, and not involved. Just see how you're breathing, how you're doing, how you're feeling, how the whole well-being of this body. More you can see the whole well-being, this body, it will connect to see how the well-being of your mind. Okay, so see how the well-being of body first. Okay, and start from mindfulness of body, outside, inside, or the whole well-being. Then you can see all the functioning of body, four elements, all the vital signs, it become relaxed, it refreshment, it healthiness, and stay there. Now, if you would like to develop more powerful awareness, just open eye. The same time you open eye and you are able to be aware of the whole well-being, then this is a good technique to develop powerful awareness. Okay. Because even you open eye, even you listen to my talk, you are able or not to develop awareness, seeing the whole well-being. What happening now? You can see the whole well-being of this body into four elements. Four elements working properly. Air element, fire element, temperature make you feel healthy. And then before you close your eyes, just develop smile, breathe in your heart. So that when you awareness seeing the whole well-being of body, if you anchor your mind, your heart with smiling, joy, and bliss. When you see the whole well-being of body, you can see the whole well-being of your mind as well, okay? So before you close your eye, wake up, seeing the whole body, well-being first, well-being of the whole body, and then before you close your eye, make sure you can see the well-being in your mind by smile and relax and joy and letting go. Now you can see a little from awareness, seeing the whole well-being of body, you can see together how the quality of your mind. Can you see? And then can you see body and mind, the whole well-being? But anyhow, today the first lesson, seeing the whole well-being of body first. And tomorrow, we develop more, seeing the whole well-being of your sensual pleasure, of your mind activity, of your mental quality. Okay? We must start today with experience, seeing the whole well-being of body, breathing nicely, smoothly, relaxingly first. By opening eye, we start by opening eye for 5 or 10 minutes to get experience how you see the whole well-being in daily life, because in daily life you open eye. So now just silent meditation, seeing the whole well-being of body by opening eye. for 5 or 10 minutes first. When you open eye, not focus anything, just see thing clearly. See more the present moment in front of you. I see everybody. I not focus one by one. If I focus one by one, I will lose my awareness. Okay? So can you see me, see the Buddha statue, see everything in front? Can you see? Then just not lost your eyesight. Your eyesight see everything in front. Okay? Then this, I use the word my sight. My sight. Okay? More you seeing by awareness, it becomes my sight. Okay? M-I-N-D, my sight. Okay? Or you got like the holiness got radiation or my sight, seeing yourself. And stay conscious, seeing the whole well-being. 5 minutes. Seeing the whole well-being of body, the whole, outside and inside together. More seeing the whole well-being, it becomes more well-being. Okay? You can realize more relaxing, more well-being. Even you are at home, you got children, your eye look at children, okay? But you got your mindfulness awareness, seeing you still okay, you still got whole well-being or not? Then your mind not disturb. It's very peaceful. And more you see the whole well-being of body, automatically you got awareness and see nice and natural breathing. Doesn't matter long or short, soft or subtle, but you can see it more smoothly. Not stuck, not got stuck. You got very smooth breathing. Because more seeing the whole well-being of body, breathing is also a part of body, okay? So we seeing the whole first. Then what happening? You got mindfulness of natural breathing. In and pause and breathing. You got very good mindfulness of breathing in and go to pause. Stop 2 seconds and then breathing out. And you feel very relaxed. Enter your mind and heart with bliss and joy and loving kindness. More you got awareness and see the whole well-being of body. You can see what happening to body, the whole well-being. What happening, that means you can get contemplation of how well-being is. This is what the Buddha used the word, contemplation of breathing, contemplation of body, okay? You get contemplation not from thought, from awareness. More seeing the whole well-being of body, more good quality of your mind, mental quality arising. And what not good, release. All disturbance, release. And good quality, calm and cool in your mind, arising. So it will connect, seeing more the quality of mind and more the whole well-being of your mind. So first, mindfulness seeing the whole well-being of body first. Then your mind got relaxed and let go something you attached for long, long time. When you got good well-being of body, your heart become more happy. Happiness. So you can see it's very simple in daily life. You take care of your children, they're very naughty, let them do naughty, but you only feel healthiness, you can see health, well-being of yourself all the time, then you not disturbed. Then you're not worried, not scary, don't worry anything. Thing will happen. This is, we call release of attachment or worry on those, on this, or release. Because more well-being of your body, most important, okay? And you can rely every moment of breathing nicely, gently, and remind yourself one day, if you near to death, the last minute come, no scary. Just see the whole well-being of your mind not scary. Then you can get more awareness, seeing breathing as the present moment until the last breath, then you wake up. And bye-bye, I rebirth to the higher level, okay? So this is vipassana, okay? See yourself. But you listen to my talk or not? This is concentration. But before you too much concentration, too much focus. It look like you too much concentration in the same way you focus how to make money. Okay? But your body is not outside. You don't have to focus too much. Okay? Money is somewhere, but body is here. You only feel, feeling first, feeling and aware. Aware and see the whole well-being of body. Body is here, not somewhere else, okay? So this we call right concentration. Right concentration, we just develop mindfulness concentration. Even you open eye, you got concentration on my talk, listening to my talk, you still mindful and aware of the whole well-being or not. That you fulfillment, mindfulness of body and body in the body. And then the whole well-being will help you realize good vital sign. Sometime today or someday you tired, vital sign is not good. More you awareness seeing the whole well-being of this body, it got healthiness, vital sign. And more seeing the whole well-being of body, then breathing will bring more awareness and see the well-being of the mental quality. It connects, body and mind connect with breathing. Seeing the whole well-being of body and seeing how breathing naturally go inside, more going inside, you got connected and see the whole well-being of your mind together. So seeing the whole well-being of body with nice, gentle breathing, relaxing breathing, smooth breathing, then you can see the whole well-being of your mind as well, okay? That's why we contemplation of breathing together, more contemplation of breathing from awareness. It will bring you to realize the mental phenomena, the mental quality. But you got stuck. The Buddha tell you mindfulness of breathing, but you do concentration of breathing, then you got stuck. Mindfulness of breathing will bring you go inside. Concentration of breathing will bring you stay here on the north tip. You only stay here knowing nothing. Stay here, only still and calm, no wisdom, okay? So mindfulness of breathing, not concentration of breathing. Otherwise you got stuck and very serious meditation. Then not see the whole well-being of your mind cannot, okay? Now mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of body first and breathe naturally, nicely. Sometimes breathing in long or short doesn't matter, but more your awareness of breathing inside, you can see the whole well-being of your mind, the mental quality, good or bad, something bad, release. And good and wholesome become more. With breathing, the Buddha say, mindfulness of breathing will make your body not difficult, your mind not difficult. So then don't worry about kilesa, don't worry. Only mindfulnessing the whole well-being of body until you got natural breathing, gentle breathing, and all natural breathing will clean and clear your dirty mind. And then you got pure mind and good mind, wholesome mind wake up. And even you close your eye, can you still mindfulness seeing the whole well-being of this body? Seeing by awareness, can you? Seeing the whole well-being of body first. Even crossing eye, but can you see yourself, the whole well-being of body? Very simple. This is will help you see the whole body outside and inside. One word, the whole well-being. Calm and conscious. Before you got calmness, but unconscious, don't know. Don't know you're breathing. Don't know you're sitting and fall asleep. Don't know, even you fall asleep. Today, calm and conscious. More and more mindfulness seeing the whole well-being of body, then you got seeing as well formation of mind, thought arising, it disappearing. Okay? Stay on the bank of the river. The bank of the river is the body. Not jump inside your mind. Stay here. People don't know. They try to focus body, focus sensation, focus mind activity, focus mental phenomena. They lost. Okay? We just wake up and see. Seeing with awareness. Okay? Seeing with awareness, seeing body. What? How you see body? Seeing the whole well-being of body. More you see the whole well-being of body, it become more open consciousness, open access into your mind, open. And you feel more relaxed, and more you can see the whole well-being of your mind inside. People don't know, they try to look into the mind inside, then they lost. We just look at the present moment, our job, okay, our work, our children, look at the way, look at our eating, but mindfulness see the well-being of your body when you eating, when you eating too much, too fast, not well-being, okay? Or when you walk in a rush, oh, tired, not well-being. So when you can see the whole well-being, you got fulfillment of mindfulness regarding the body outside and inside. And what happening? More seeing the whole well-being of body, you can feel vital sign work properly. Heartbeat properly. Pulsation work properly. Temperature work properly. Okay? You can feel vital sign work properly. Yeah? Good. And confirmed by the Buddha. Develop mindfulness of body as in Pali word, kayakata sati, or mindfulness of body, or mindfulness immersed throughout the whole body. Everywhere got mindfulness of body. Okay? This will fulfill the four foundation of mindfulness. One practice, mindfulness of the body, the whole body will fulfill the four foundation of mindfulness. This is confirmed by the sutta. So in daily life, you already develop mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of body. Now, instead of you immediately closing eye, this is not wake up, okay? But wake up first. Wake up and able to see how you doing, how you feeling with your body. That means wake up with seeing the whole well-being of your body first. And instead of concentration of breathing, when you wake up, it come to contemplation of breathing from awareness, okay? Different. Concentration, your mind got attached. Contemplation, your mind got wisdom, okay? Mindfulness regarding body by seeing the whole well-being of the body. And even you close your eye, you can see how good mindfulness of the whole well-being of body with contemplation, with wisdom. So now you got contemplation of the whole body, that is breathing and the whole well-being of body together. Now just develop more contemplation of breathing in and together, contemplation of the whole well-being of body together, because Breathing is a part of body. Mindfulness of the whole body, that means contemplation of breathing and contemplation of body, seeing the whole well-being of body together, and close your eyes. Contemplation more on breathing and the whole well-being of body, that's all. Good start, already success, more than 50% already, good start. Contemplation of the whole well-being is not from your thought, it's from awareness. Awareness is your spiritual. Awareness will tell you how to see the whole well-being. Awareness will tell you smile. Awareness will tell you relax. Awareness will tell you letting go. Seeing and letting go. Seeing and letting go. Without awareness, you got attachment, okay? Awareness is the wisdom. From awareness, it will getting more intuitive knowledge or the wisdom, okay? Intuitive knowledge is not from the thought, it's from awareness. Awareness of the present moment, of how the well-being of body. And now it depends on how you stay conscious, how long? You stay conscious on seeing the whole well-being of body for 10 minutes, you got meditation 10 minutes. You stay 2 minutes and lost in thought, you got meditation 2 minutes. Okay? So now just stay conscious. Stay conscious. People don't know. They always try to do concentration. But today we not do concentration. We stay mindful. We stay aware, we stay conscious, because what we will go is to go more consciousness, to go more awareness, to go more mindfulness, okay? Stay mindful, stay aware of the whole well-being of body with accept and understanding. Stay aware, then you got seeing from awareness. Stay mindful, then you got seeing from mindfulness. Okay? Seeing from awareness, it comes from inside. Inside you are spiritual. Then your spiritual wake up. Stay aware, then you got seeing how the well-being, seeing how doing, how the well-being, that is contemplation, okay? You got seeing how, you got knowledge, how well-being, okay? Now see how well-being, or one word, contemplation, okay, of body. Seeing how well-being of body, of the whole body first. seeing how well-being, then you can see what's happening. That is, you got contemplation, seeing what's happening. That is vipassana. And develop contemplation. Not only how well-being of body, how well-being of your mind. When you can see how well-being of body, then you can see how well-being of your mind and mental quality as well. Develop more contemplation, seeing how your mind is, how your body is, how your mind is, how well-being of your body is. Then you can see how well-being of your mind is. And anchor your mind, your heart with bliss and joy. Then you are able to see how well-being of your mind. Or smiling a bit, not serious meditation. Then it becomes consciousness, wake up from subconscious. People got sleeping in subconsciousness, but today, when you can see more how well-being of body, you got more consciousness wake up from the subconsciousness. That means you got more well-being of your mind because you turn over. Subconscious turn over to more consciousness. And from turning over more and more, it become Dhamma eye. More and more consciousness. Now you got only consciousness turn over about 20%, 30%, not enough, okay? But it will more turn over if you see how well-being of body in daily life and more see how well-being of body, then you can see how well-being of your mind, it become more conscious, more smiling, more loving kindness, more rejoice, more happiness, okay? And with breathing, contemplation of how well-being of the whole body and breathing together, breathing will open up your mind, become more consciousness, wake up, breathing. More seeing well-being of body, then breathing become longer and deeper and will open up your mind, the subconsciousness become more consciousness, then you are so bliss and gladness and free from suffering. And now even you open eye, just in daily life, I talk to you, you talk to me, but you never see how well-being of body is not difficult because now you get aging, more aging. If you can see more how well-being of body, your you got good health. If you work and you not see how well-being of body, then maybe you got sick, you don't know, okay? Always work enough, not only work for money, work for good health, okay? Make money, not only for money, but make money with good health, okay? Not only focus how to make money, but together focus how to make money, but more awareness seeing you still got good health, got good well-being or not. Good well-being, then you got very good mindfulness, you got good insight, you got insight and wisdom, and then you got letting go, freedom of mind and equality of mind, okay, together. Otherwise, you got money, you got whatever you want, you still suffering, okay, because you never see how you got good well-being. In what level? This is enough. You have good well-being. This is good already. Okay? Let it be. And then we do it again tomorrow. Today enough. This is more important. And then when you got seeing good well-being of body, your breathing become longer. Your breathing longer, you got your long life. If you are breathing short, that means you breathing very fast because you are very crazy. You are looking for something outside, and until you got in a hurry, you're breathing very, very short and fast. You know, those animals, all animals, breathing 1 minute, maybe 70 times, 80 times, like a fox, okay? Then life only 2 years, 3 years and die. Because our heartbeat got limited. Limited for heartbeat maybe I don't know how many terabytes inside heartbeat. But if you already use your heartbeat too fast, always angry, always desire, then your heartbeat already fast, then you got limitation. It maybe you can stay until 80 years old, but you are in a hurry, every day in a rush. Then you maybe stay only 40, 50 years because you are too hurry. Okay? You are too hurry. Okay? This is the scientist got research. I got this research. Wow, very good. Every human being got limitation of heartbeat. You only calm and cool, you got slow motion heartbeat, then your life is long, okay? The dog, the cat, breathing very fast, okay? Because they got eager, desire to fight for food, for whatever, then heartbeat very fast. Life is short, okay? 5-10 years, or 5 years, then they die. So now you are a human being. In a minute, how many times you breathing? If more you calmness in meditative state, maybe in 1 minute, 5, 6, 7 times, or maybe 5 or 4 times in the meditative state, okay? Then you must rest, take a rest, your heartbeat, okay? Okay, now open eye. Any question now? Because I will develop more. We have another session. Any question? You catch what I'm explaining to you? And then we just review. Every time before you finish, not hurry to come out. Just stay mindful. Review what you learn. How you feel calmness, how you feel mindfulness, how you feel awareness, review, then you get more knowledge. Okay? If when you finish meditation, then come out quickly. Then you get nothing because you not review. More review, it will connect to the next session. Okay? Tomorrow When you sit, you review today, tomorrow you sit, it come to your mind, okay? I got this technique from my master. My master say, hey, just slowly come out from meditation. Review how you practice 2 minutes, 3 minutes first. Now review what you learned today. How well-being of your body, how well-being of your mind. Then you can see the progress. Next time you practice, you get more progress. If you not review, you always start from 1, 2, 3. If you review, then you start from 10, 11. Okay? Review first. Review, you know, before you come out from the meditation, okay? The last minute, so good. Can you review, then you can absorb. Absorb the last minute of meditation. Oh, how is so nice, so peaceful, review. Then when you review next session or tomorrow, next week, you sit. It will recall your mind. Here, the way. If you not review, then next week, you don't know how to get inside. Okay? Review 2-3 minutes first. Review your practice, you can realize something better. You can realize less thought, less emotion. You can realize your progress. And then you review more, you can see the way, just stay conscious, stay mindful, stay aware, that's why. I just tell you, when you come to see the well-being of your body, I just tell you stay mindful, stay aware, but somebody cannot. But if you more review, then sometime more review next session, I tell you stay aware, it can't happening by itself, okay? Stay mindful, not do anything. You not review, then you have to do concentration, to do mindfulness, to do awareness, very tired. Okay? Review, very important. I review my practice more than 20 years. When I was 20 years old, my master tell me, hey, not naughty boy, not quickly come out, stay mindful, review your practice 2 minutes. My master remind me, review. Review more, you get seeing something, seeing more progress, okay? Review. Good? Now, any questions?